honey, when are you going to get your car back from the shop?
This afternoon. I hope. Why?
Well, because it's your day to take Will's carpool.
No, because they're animals.
No, they are not. You just have to be firm with them.
I am. They take those little gummy bears, you know. They get them all smoochy, and then they bing you right in the back of the ear.
Well, I'm sorry, but you're going to have to do it because I'm in court all day.
Car's been in the shop for 2 days. How long does it take to... You know anything about cars?
Well, I spent many a long hour watching my daddy's head under the hood in that old Packard that we had.
Oh, well, he must have taught you a lot then.
Yeah. Taught me that fixing an automobile is one of the most frustrating things that a human being can do. That's why I buy a new one every year.
Well, maybe Ponder will let you use his car.
Yeah. No. No gummy bears in my Buick. See? But I will let you have my van if you make a few deliveries.
Do I get to keep the tips?
Hi, Coach.
Ah, well, Shirley.
Shirley. Great timing. When will my car be done?
Well, Coach, that's hard to say.
Well, try.
I'll give it to you straight. Your ports are clogged, and you haven't got a good gas-to-air mix.
Your ports are clogged.
What does that mean?
The hell if I know, honey. Is that expensive?
Well, Coach, that's hard to say.
Everything's hard to say today, isn't it, Julie?
Coach, clogged ports is not something you want to take lightly.
No.
Listen, I have to go pick up my lunch. I'll call you later with an estimate.
I'm glad she didn't give you the estimate now. I wouldn't want you to show up at my poker game on Friday with your wallet flat.
No, he's not going to be playing poker on Friday night because we're going to go to that new French restaurant.
What the hell's a clogged port?
Hey, Herm.
Oh, hey, Shirley.
Oh, when I came out of my apartment this morning, I slipped on a greasy spot in your parking space. You have an oil leak. You may want me to take a look at that.
Oh, thanks for telling me. I'll call you about it in a couple of days or something. Hey, Coach.
Herman?
I need to talk to you. Could we talk in private?
I was just getting ready to check on the ribs in the oven.
We're family. It's okay.
Oh, all right. All right, here's the deal. Margaret's been writing me these erotic letters about her innermost sexual fantasies.
I'm going to check on the rest of the fun.
No, Coach. Listen to this. You got to hear this.
Uh-huh.
My beloved Herman. So dazzling and ruddy.
What?
You are my love stallion. Fill me up with fill me up with your words of love.
Oh.
And then it segues from there into this three-act fantasy sequence complete with exotic perfumes, costume changes, special effects. Go ahead, read it. Give me the goosebumps.
Yeah, me too. Well, let's go.
You know, this doesn't even sound like Margaret. I mean, and it's not even signed. Maybe it's a student who's got a crush on
you. Oh, Ava, no. Now, if it was a high school girl, you'd be able to tell because the little eyes would be dotted with little hearts.
Oh.
It's Margaret, and I know it's Margaret. You see, I was over at her house the other night, spackling some picture holes.
Uh-huh.
And there it was. It was right there on her nightstand. Women on top. You know, that book, that new book about women's innermost fantasies.
Yeah.
I tell you, a night alone with that book, that'd set a woman on fire.
Well, good luck with cooling her off. Let's go.
Look, I don't want to cool her off. I just want to harness her.
No, we don't want to get involved.
You know, this letter is probably Margaret's way of expressing herself without risking rejection.
Oh, stop it.
Stop it.
No, I'm just trying to help.
No, with his sex life, you don't want to help that.
You know, I think she's just trying to tell you exactly what she wants.
We're dead. He's gonna be calling all hours of the night, giving us instant replay.
Are you telling me you think I ought to give her what she wants?
That's up to you.
Matador style, or as I'm known in the shadow of your dreams.
The
El hombre del grande.
For goodness sakes, take off that silly outfit. You look like one of the village people. What in the world has come over you?
Blue Spanish eyes.
Mr. Stiles, I have a great deal of work to do. I have to get ready for my meeting with the county superintendent on Friday, and besides, my eyes are not blue.
Then brown Spanish eyes.
Mr. Stiles, you're starting to scare me.
Oh, come on, Margaret. Let your imagination just run wild. Listen for the snapping of those castanets.
Oh! The only thing I hear snapping is your mind.
I'm yours.
What if somebody walks in?
You are mine.
Del El Hombre Del Grande locked the door on his way in?
Si.
Bueno.
So, what comes next?
Oh, come on, Margaret. These tights are riding up on me. Don't make me fly solo here. You know good and well what comes next.
Pardon me?
The other stuff. I left it out in the car. You know, the sangria, oven mitts, sponge bat.
What in the hell are you talking about?
The stuff that you mentioned in your letter.
My beloved Herman, so dazzling and ruddy. This is disgusting. This is vile. This is obscene. And I have never used the word ruddy in my life.
You mean you didn't write this letter?
Of course not.
Never mind.
What I want to know is who did write this letter.
Well, obviously, I thought you did, or I wouldn't be sitting here looking like the Cisco Kid.
Such a thing, and that is not even my handwriting.
Oh, come on, Margaret. I was at your house the other night. I saw that book on your nightstand.
What book?
Women on Top.
Oh, my mother sent me that. She thought it was about women climbing the corporate ladder. But believe you me, I have no intention of working my way to the top in leather underwear.
Then if you didn't write this letter, oh, Margaret, that means anybody could have.
Well, anybody better not be sending you any more such letters. You better figure out who did it and put a stop to it.
Don't worry, I will figure out who did it, and I will put a stop to it. In the meantime, little outfit's running through the weekend.
Mr. Stiles!
Coach, I've been racking my brains all night. I think I've got it finally narrowed down to about 125 suspects.
125? Well, that's a good question.
Yeah.
Paul Abdul.
No, that was just doodling.
Junior Roberts?
All right, some of it's a wish list.
Yeah.
Look, I just wish this mystery woman would reveal herself. That way I could heal her pain and let her down easy.
Right. Let me see that list. Give that here. Oh, Tammy Jarvis. She's that little bombshell that used to do nail wraps down at the Hair Hut.
Oh, she is.
You wish.
Yeah.
Mildred Cook?
I don't think so. She died 4 months ago.
Nobody told me.
Oh. Brenda Dempster.
Irene Duvall.
What the hell is my name doing on this list?
Play a little music. I run a family business. I wouldn't want to see any dishes broken.
I do not intend to break any dishes. I just really want to know what kind of twisted thinking is going on in that balding little pinhead of yours.
B7, I like that.
Can you actually picture me at home, alone, in my champagne-colored silk peignoir, drinking my cafe au lait with mint, and saying to myself, I'm just going to have to send a note over to that strapping young Herman Stiles. Because I do spend the better part of every day fantasizing about him and me and the back of some uncomfortable chair.
cross y'all list.
Thank you. And now, if you will excuse me, I have to go eat my meat.
Look, Coach Newton.
Hi, Margaret.
Mrs. Stiles, someone left this package for you at the school.
Well, thanks.
You know, I may have come down a little hard on you last night. I don't want to blow this out of proportion. Let's just put together the shattered remnants of our friendship and get on with our lives.
Believe me, Margaret, there's nothing I'd like better than just to be able to forget this whole thing happened.
What the hell is that?
It's sure not the abdominizer I ordered.
Well, I see. Well, I certainly hope they fit.
Oh, come on, Margaret. How did I get myself into these things?
One leg at a time, I think.
Boys, but she's coming here tonight. Look, Coach, I'm going to have to call you later. I got to get hold of myself. Okay, Stiles, just relax. Just be calm and cool. Hey, Shirley, look, I can't visit right now. I'm expecting company.
I am the company. Anything like this before.
But then again, I've never felt like this before. It's like I have no choice.
Oh, no, 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 no. Shirley, you do have a choice. That's what America's all about. Free choice. Why don't we take a look at that oil leak you were telling me about? I wouldn't want toxins to seep into the water table.
Oh, don't fight me, Herman. After all, you did invite me here. You must want this as much as I do. I thought for so long about what it was that I was going to tell you. We're soulmates, Herman Stiles. I know you. I feel your loneliness and your pain. I see it in the Campbell's Soup for One cans that you take out to the curb every Wednesday morning. I hear it in every beat of your heart. Sometimes the pounding throb and music of it makes me want to go crazy.
That's very poetic.
In a very terrifying sort of way. Look, I think it would be a real good idea now if you just go on home.
Oh, I'll go home. I'll go. Just as soon as we're both quenched and exhausted.
I'm feeling perfectly well, Quinn.
Herman! Herman, not.
Margaret! Good news. Found out who's been sending me those letters. Hey, good morning.
Oh, good morning, Herman.
I'm really sorry to bother y'all this early in the morning, but look, I got big trouble here.
What? Oh, is Margaret still not talking to you?
Ava, it's like I don't even exist. She won't talk to me. If I call her, she won't return my calls. I tell you, if this Shirley girl doesn't leave me alone pretty soon, Margaret's not ever going to have anything to do with me again. And you want to hear the worst part of it?
No. I want Shirley to fix my car. I get it. Okay. Hello. Hi, Ponder. Yeah, I'd be glad to make a delivery. What is it?
Oh, right there. Yeah.
10 pounds of chipped brisket. Where'd that go? Heaven can wait. Rest home. Want any extra sauce for that, pal? Same to you. This is getting out of hand. Now, you've got to straighten this thing out here with Shirley, because I'm in the meat hauling business.
Look, I'm all ears. Tell me what to do.
Well, it's obvious that this girl is obsessed with you, which makes her nuts. Now, what we got to do, she has made you into a kind of fantasy figure, see? Someone that can't do anything wrong. Now, what you have to do is show her that you are not that person, you are someone else.
Oh, I get it. You're good.
Mm.
You're real good. You know, you could make a living doing this sort of thing. Don't you worry about a thing. You're gonna be out of the meat hauling business before you know it. I'm not only good at reeling them in, I can throw them back.
Bonsoir. My name is Henri. I will be your waiter this evening.
Hank, what are you doing? This is Hank. You know, he flips the yard markers on the game.
Yeah.
Coach, management wants us to sound like we're French.
You don't sound French, Hanky. You sound stupid.
Okay. What do you have?
Ooh, well, this whole menu's in French.
Yes?
Honey, you're the expert. Huh. You order for us.
Sure. Deux.
Deux.
Perdue.
Perdue.
La spéciale. La chelée.
Oui, oui, monsieur.
So what did he order?
I have absolutely no idea. He's gonna walk back to that cook and point like he did.
Yeah, come on, what did you order?
I ordered the special of the house for two.
Oh, I thought house was maison.
I just whim a little passion, Princess.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh, my gosh, is that Herman?
Mm-hmm.
There's Bud to have to kick to get a table around here.
That would be mine, sir.
Well, hey, Pedro, how about showing us where we can sit down and tie on no feedback?
Perhaps you'd like to check your hat, sir.
Looks fine to me.
You're the envy of the restaurant.
What is he doing?
I have no idea.
I've been curious about this place. I'm so glad you suggested it. I thought as long as we have to spend an evening going over personnel reports, we might as well enjoy it as much as we can.
Good evening, ladies. Follow me.
Oh, my Lord.
Yes?
Could we please sit over there?
Certainly.
It looked a little crowded.
Margaret's here and Herman's here. Honey, you're gonna have to do something.
What?
Come on over here and sit next to me. I won't be able to blow in the air.
Herman, you're so aggressive.
Oh, that's just my old animal nature talking. You know, raw. Danger. Look, honey, it's not your cup of tea.
Whatever you do is my cup of tea.
Today?
Yes. I admit I was a little surprised at first. But now I realize how right I was about the two of us. We are twin rivers running wild and free, and when we come together, we create a crashing torrent of passion that knows no boundaries.
Never heard a mechanic talk like you do before.
If it's wild you want, then that's what I'll be. Kiss me.
All those breadsticks all over the floor.
You're my breadstick.
Waiter! Waiter!
Excuse me, Mrs. Stiles.
Margaret!
I have never been so embarrassed by anyone in my entire life.
Margaret, I can explain
Please,
everything.
Save your breath. Goodbye, Mr. Stiles.
Oh, Margaret, come on, please.
Don't let her go, Herman. She could never handle a man like you.
Hi, Margaret.
Hi.
Nice place, huh?
Yes, it is. Although I can't say I care for the clientele.
Sit down just a minute. Please.
Coach, what are you doing here?
Yes, and pardon me for butting in, but I don't see how this is exactly your business.
It's my business because the two of you are friends of mine, and I think you should talk. Sit down. And because Shirley is holding my car hostage. I want it back.
Well, I feel completely and utterly humiliated.
Well, Margaret, so do I.
I know just how y'all feel. These people aren't buying my accent worth beans.
Shut up, Hank.
Pardonnez-moi.
Now, look, you were right about us. We're a lot alike. Up until just a few months ago, I didn't have much of a love life either. But the universe has this way of letting us all know that we're entitled to love and be loved. You see, I found somebody. I think. And you're gonna find somebody too, because you're a real nice lady. You don't have to be embarrassed about anything. We got to go out after love any way we know how.
Thank you, Herman. Sorry, Miss Fatch. I guess I'm just used to going after whatever I want as hard as I can.
Well, he is a fine man.
Listen, you ever change your mind, you know where to find me. Goodbye, El Hombre del Grande.
Why don't you come with us, Shirley? We'll go over to Ponda Blues and have some really good food. You know, I know how you feel. You know, you're heartbroken. The best thing to do is just jump right into work.
I never meant to do anything to embarrass you.
Well, I guess your heart was in the right place.
And I meant what I said.
Mr. Stiles, you have said a great many things this evening. You're going to have to be a little more specific.
I never knew that much about love till I met you.
Oh, that part. Me neither. Thank you.
Oh, Mark.
Well, I guess I better get back to my dinner. I suggest you go home and change.
Good idea.
You want to stop by my house later?
I'd love that.
You don't still have that cape, do you?
Brown Spanish eyes.
Hi, Mark McEwen here. You know, Monday is very funny, but did you know that Wednesday is funny too? First, Emmy winner Jonathan Winters stars in Davis Rules. Then, it's the Golden Globe winner for Best Comedy Series, Brooklyn Bridge. It's an all-funny Wednesday. To all those who love great comedy, stand up and say aye, and keep standing, and get ready for an all-new Major Dad next.